Hello everyone, it's Alex from Bad Decks Played Badly, and this is match number 3 of Smothering Espezoa. If you want to check out what's in the deck, check out the description down below. We'll see, yes. We're currently, game-wise, 2-2 and 1-1 on your matches. We went against a complete noob in game number 1. I'm going to keep this. Went against a complete noob in game number 1 and just wrecked them, and then we went against Tron in our second game. It was a pretty spicy Tron deck. It was just a burn deck, but Tron. It was kind of cool, actually. I quite liked it. However, it didn't go very well. They had Ensnaring Bridge in game number 2, and that was just enough to just smash our deck. You know, Dimir doesn't really deal well with artifacts once they've resolved, so it was a bit of an issue. I will actually mention, however, if you're watching this on the day of release, it should be Tuesday. I hope you guys are sending your love and prayers out to me, because I'll probably be in surgery for my leg, or at least at the hospital waiting for surgery. So send the love, because unfortunately I don't think after this deck there may not be one for a little bit more time. I'm not sure. I'll see how it goes, see how the recovery goes, see how my stairs treat me with my stupid broken leg. So yeah, I thought I'd get that off my chest. Seems to be going okay. So yeah, they're playing the Scrylands, good old Scrylands. And yeah, I'm going to play Ethereum Sculptor and hopefully they don't kill it. They probably will, but we shall see. We've actually got a really good start, in all honesty. If I draw a land now, this is like, I can't think of a better start this deck can have. Because if I draw a land, I can play Psy. Then after that, I can play two Prophetic, a Service Schematic and a Prophetic Prism. Oh, awesome. Right, okay, let's do this. And then I can just kind of go off and... Are they going to Fatal Push? They've got black. Okay, yeah, this is going very, very well so far, actually. I'm going to fetch up a... We're going to fetch up. Okay, a Breeding Pool. Cool. If you guys didn't know before, I think I mentioned it in a previous video, Breeding Pools are really cheap at the moment. I don't know why. So if you want to get your fetch lands for the old Simic colours, but not the actual fetch part, Misty Rainforest is still really expensive, but the Breeding Pools are very cheap. Okay. What a card. Search library and or graveyard for a creature card with convert mana cost X or less and put it onto the battlefield. If you search a library for this, way shuffle it. If X is 10 or more, create creatures you control. Okay. Target creature you control explores, you may play an additional land this turn. I mean, look at this. Wow. So we're now finding out why, what was it called? I can't remember, it's going to drive me nuts now. Finale of Devastation, there was another one, which cost basically one less green, and it was banned because Dryad Arbor. But we'll see how this goes. Our opponent's definitely playing some, they're obviously deck building like they know what they're doing. Okay, so I'm going to, I'll just play two of these right now. Get my Phopters going. Problem is, because we're playing a deck with green, they're going to have a lot of enchantment hate and all that stuff. I'm going to play Espezoa right now. Sweet. We're doing okay. And pass the turn. Considering it's turn... Is that turn 3? I can never tell where you can find which turn it is. I think we're doing pretty good. What are you going to do now? Search library for a swamp, of course. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Oh, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So we've got 6 lands right now. They're doing okay, because then we have 3. Oh, no. I've seen this in a few preview videos. So what's this? But I said, look at the top card of your library anytime. You may play the top card of your library. If you cast a spell this way, pay life equal to converted mana cost rather than pay its mana. Okay. Sacrifice 10 non-permanents. Each opponent loses 10 life. Oof, okay. So it is going to kind of go off now? Yeah, okay. If they want to pay life, that's cool. I mean, They're not gaining any life with their Jade Light Ranger. Phantasmal Image. Great, great magic card. Enter the Unknown. Just checking what everything else they've played. Okay, Surge of Library for a Swamp or Forest card. Very, very good. So yeah, these guys have exploded out the gates too. I'm probably going to return Servo Schematic. Play for Prophetic Prism. Draw a card. I'm probably just going to kill that now. We're actually in a really good spot right now, so an all-out attack could really, really kind of put them on the back foot. Because if they're going to be, paying for stuff with life, then we should be doing okay. They've got a turn to kill us, or just completely sweep your board. Whenever a creature you control explores, put a 1/1. Yes, very good. So they're going to be gaining life, but can they gain enough life? That's the point. Okay. So you're gonna get another Jade Light. Yes, they are. I thought so. I mean, they're still gaining a lot of life, but it still doesn't really matter. Actually, no, that does matter a bit. Sauron's Vengeance deals 10 damage to target player or planeswalker and you gain 10 life. Okay. Well, I can definitely see that is, yeah, wow. Are you going off? Ah, oh, this is such a good card, isn't it? Okay, and lost. Okay, so what do I need to bring in? You are coming in. Your Nulls are coming in. No, Defense Grid, that's fine. Damping Sphere, I don't need that either. Okay, I'm going to take out a Sentinel Totem. I mean, Navigator's Compass would be quite good as well, actually. So I'm going to take out just two Weaponcraft Enthusiasts and maybe one Fopter Spy Network and see how this goes. I'm going to open my drink now, so if you hear a fizz. Nope. Alright, cool. Right. I will play first. Okay, this isn't bad. If they have removal, which I'm almost adamant they will, this could go really bad. I mean, their deck is spicy, I'll give them that. I think they got a little bit lucky, in all honesty. Just a bit. We're not off to the best start. I mean, we've got pieces, but we kind of need land. Yep, let you scry. Sweet. I really, really want to have drawing in a null would be really good. A null is kind of what we want. That's our sideboard piece we really want. I mean, the good thing about their deck is that they've still got big creatures which can just beat down either way. Okay, cool. I mean, it's not great, but hopefully we can draw into more land. That will do very nicely. And I'm going to just straight up play an Espezoa right now and go in attacking. So we'll put them on a clock. Okay. So we're going to have to deal with artifact hate. We know this going in. Unless they're just so quick, then whatever. We can't do anything about it. Cool. I mean, I'm loving the synergies in this deck. So what's Commander Dreadhorde? Choose any number of target creatures and or planeswalker with cards in graveyard. Commander Dreadhorde deals damage to you equal to the total converted mana cost of these cards. Put them onto the battlefield under your control. Oh, right. I mean, these guys are playing some spice. I'll give them that. They're exploring again? That's ludicrous, isn't it? I mean, you got to remember this is turn three. Turn three, they've got four lands, oh, five lands, and a 5/7 down. That's just, and they're up to 22 life. I mean, these guys, they're not messing about. Always yield. I'll put my prism back. So I kind of want to play a Psy and just get going, but I'm just going to attack for now. It doesn't have reach, does it? No, it doesn't. Okay. So get an attack in. There we go. So play a Cog Workers, Plasma Knot. Get a Servo for chump blocking duties. Play a Prophetic Prism. Excellent. And play an Ichor Wellspring. Sweet. Okay. So our engine's kind of going now. If everything lives, and we live, more importantly. Okay. Are they going to attack? Okay, they're not attacking. Yeah, Prophetic Prism back. Play another Dark Slick Shores. And now we are going to Psy. And play a Prism. So this is going really well so far. So, and they've left three land up, so I'm kind of worried something awful's going to happen to us. I mean, Wildgrowth Walker is a cool card if you find the right deck. I mean, a two drop, that's now 5/7. I spent Tarmogoyf in this deck anyway. So yeah, they're going all out. They haven't got any trample though, and they have kind of they get to a point now where they're running out of stuff to play. If they've got any removal, they've got kind of two targets they want to go. Espezoa or Psy. Either one, they're going to want to get rid of very quickly. I'm going to go with Prophetic Prism again. Play Creeping Tar Pit. And I'm going to go with Trading Post for now. It's pretty cheap. And play a Wellspring. And do I want to play anything else? I'm not going to play anything else, just in case they do what they did previously and just burn me out. I kind of want to be able to discard a card and gain four life, just in case they just go along that plan. I don't want to get too greedy. Okay. So you're going for a Jade Light? I assume so. You're going to gain a ridiculous amount of life. Look at those triggers, eh? So yeah, they've got some big creatures down now. But lucky for us, we're doing okay life-wise. I can actually sacrifice an artifact and draw a card, which I'm actually really tempted to do. Chomp block and sacrifice. Yeah, so I'll block the biggest one. Okay. And I'm going to Sacrifice artifact and draw a card. Oh, is it? Sacrifice a creature. Yeah, why can't I? Okay, cool. Right, for some reason I always had a... That weirded me out then for some reason. Don't ask me why. yep, get the Wellspring back. Yeah, just unload my hand, basically. Unload everything, get as many Fopters as I can. That's now the plan. More chump blockers. Oh, sweet, that's what I wanted, an NL. So I'm going to keep back an NL, just in case. But yeah, we're doing good. There's no reach on you. Nope, so... So this is kind of what our deck wants to be doing, just kind of... Just overwhelming our opponents. As you can see, Esper Zoa has really, really come into its own in this deck. Ha, no thank you. Bye-bye, legendary artifact. Yes! Okay, we got a game, we got a game. Oh, what, they quit out? Don't you dare, opponent. I can't believe they quit out then. Oh, Jesus. I mean, some people on this game, I swear. I'm not playing it again. I'm taking that one as a win. I want to show you guys how the deck worked, and that was a pretty good example of how it worked. They just... You're going to get that a lot, people just rage quitting because, you know, if they win, I'll sit by and go for game number two. If I win, look at that, throwing a wobbly. What an ass. All right, well, if you guys like the deck, please subscribe. If you like what I do, you know, all that stuff. If you want to wish me good luck at the hospital, you're very, very happy to see that as well. You know what? I'm going to be sat in my hospital bed a long time with nothing but Wi-Fi on my phone. So just seeing that will probably cheer me up a bit. All right, guys. So yeah, have a good one and see you guys match number four. Bye.